Sino-American relationships in the early and mid-1900s have always been a topic of broad discussion. The extended Cold War in China had sparked distrust between the two nations, and they began to regard each other as hateful enemies. In April 1971, an extremely important event involving a table tennis tournament held in neighboring Japan took place in China and led to President Nixon's visit the following year. President Nixon was not the only individual interested in developing friendly relationships with the People's Republic of China. Mao Zedong, the communist leader of China at the time, was also very intent on welcoming Americans to China and opening new possibilities of trade with America. Ping-pong diplomacy and the exchange between Nixon thawed the previously icy Sino-American relationship, making both China and America realize their mutual goal to improve diplomatic relations and benefiting both countries economically and politically. The deterioration of the relationship between China and the United States began with 1949 when the communists led by Mao Zedong defeated nationalists in a civil war. Americans, who had clearly broadcasted their support for nationalists, regarded the communists as enemies and sent fleets to prevent them from attacking the nationalists who had fled to the small village of Taiwan. As a result, uneasy feelings developed. The two nations became enemies for the next 20 years and came head-to-head in the Cold War and the Korean War.
During the war, the United States laid a trade embargo on China, restricted America's travel rights to the country, and continued to defend and protect Taiwan with fervor. During the Korean Wars in the 1950s, the United States laid a trade embargo on China and North Korea under the Trading with the Enemy Act that prevented China from trading with America and its allies. Due to protests in 1957, America allowed its allies and China to trade, but continued to refrain from any trade with China itself. Not only was trade prohibited between China and America, but the travel of United States citizens was restricted too, and no Americans would be allowed in China for the next 20 years after the Korean War had started. The Chinese had already been upset by the fact that the people of Taiwan were not regarded as Chinese citizens, and that Taiwan considered itself a separate country. The United States' support of Taiwan made China angry and caused more conflicts and hatred to erupt. Even after a friendly visit from Nixon, the treaty and connection between the United States and Taiwan would be the largest obstacle in repairing Sino-American relationships for the next decade or so. Despite the fiery feelings that sprung up between America and China, an event Time magazine called The Ping Heard Around the World began the change of Sino-American relationships. Zhuang Zedong, a Chinese ping-pong player celebrity, told of how his actions were the first in easing tensions between the two countries when he talked to Glenn Cohen, an American ping-pong player who happened to be on a bus full of Chinese table tennis players. The two men exchanged gifts and became friendly, thus thawing the icy relationship between America and China, which had basically no political connections for 22 years. When Mao was told of the friendly exchange between the American and Chinese ping-pong teams, he immediately wanted to invite the American team to visit China, even though he was warned by the Foreign Ministry and the State Commission to delay this visit. Disregarding this advice, he invited the American team anyway. Upon hearing of this invitation, Nixon accepted the request without hesitation because he, too, was eager to begin repairing relationships with China. In order to better examine the causes and effects of ping-pong diplomacy, we interviewed Rick Perlstein, author of the book Nixonland.
What do you think pushed forth Nixon's dream of bringing China to the rest of the world?
Well, there was Nixon's personality and character. He had dreams and aspirations for being seen as a great statesman for changing the entire way the world system worked.
Mm-hmm.
There were intellectual reasons. I think he understood by talking to various defense intellectuals and foreign policy intellectuals that he could Vietnam War.
Mm-hmm.
So talk more about that. And I think, finally, the fact that China was excluded so extremely from the rest of the world by American foreign policy was pretty irrational.
Right.
That the isolation was, you know, that extreme. And often those kinds of things kind of take on a political inertia of their own.
Okay, thank you, Mr. Perlstein.
A couple of days later, on April 10, 1971, 15 Americans who were part of a group in Japan competing in the 31st World Table Tennis Championship and five journalists became the first Americans to step into China since 1949. The Americans had had an all-expense-paid tour of Beijing and enjoyed a full week there. They were treated with much respect, and the series of events that followed greatly improved Sino-American relationships as well as helped trade and political stability between the two countries. After this visit, more American journalists were welcome to visit China, and in turn, the United States lifted its prohibition of trade with China. China informed the United States that it was ready to receive America's Secretary of State, an ambassador, or even the President himself. In July of 1971, Secretary of State Henry Kissinger visited China to discuss the President's coming with Premier Zhu Zhaoenlai. The visit greatly improved and solidified healthy feelings. 7 months later, Nixon, welcomed by Mao, stayed in China for 1 week. Nixon and his wife Patricia stayed in China from February 17th to February 28th, 1972, attending shows and touring several provinces. On February 27th, the Shanghai Communique was signed and issued to the public. This important communique brought into light that both countries were interested in working towards brighter and more peaceful relations. Next year, the United States lifted its ban on traveling to China, thus making it possible for the American table tennis team to visit. After relations were mended, the United States gave 2 musk oxen to the People's Republic of China and received 2 giant pandas in return, which became symbolic of developing Sino-American relations and the good intentions of both countries.
Now that relationships with China was sealed, another piece of diplomacy came into play. Nixon had struggled with the strategic arms limitations talks with the Soviet Union in an unsuccessful attempt to gain leverage in the arms race. The U.S. had yet to force Northern Vietnam into an agreement. China's diplomacy acted as a bargaining chip to pressure Russia and Vietnam. Months after the visit, Soviet Premier Brezhnev caved under pressure, signing the first nuclear weapons control agreement. After the talk, China and Russia pressured North Vietnam into a negotiation where the U.S. completely pulled out of Vietnam to settle the war. The reason for ping-pong diplomacy and Nixon's subsequent visit to China lies in the relationship between the two countries and their cold history with one another. At the time of President Nixon's visit in 1972, the tense feelings from the Cold War still remained between America and China. The President's stay in China was meant to ease the taut relationship between the two countries. The benefits for both countries were very abundant and made the reconnection of the United States and China much more worthwhile. In addition to the reestablishment of trade, the welcoming of the American tennis team into China also made Russia and neighboring countries realize that China was capable of obtaining large and powerful allies, such as the United States. Mao was also pleased because he was recognized as the sole ruler of China by President Nixon. The results of the President and the ping-pong team's visit are remarkable, and as Zhao Enlai later stated, never before in history has a sport been used so effectively as a tool of international diplomacy. Ping-pong diplomacy definitely sparked the repairing of relationship that would have eventually happened later between China and America.